Share his remarks with you. I have a few remarks of my own. Now, I've worked with Bill for the past 16 years. He's the longest serving councilman on the Patterson Municipal Council, and I come in a close second. But what I want to share with you this evening is the importance of putting the right man in the right job for the benefit of this city. I know as city residents, if you're like me, you're tired of being seen as the laughing stock of New Jersey. You're tired of being the joke. When people say, "You from Patterson?" Then they get this look on their face, right? And I have to correct them. I said, "Yes, I'm from Patterson. I'm proud to be from Patterson. Because Patterson is a great city, and I guarantee you, if you're not originally from Patterson, someone you know is from Patterson, and someone you love is from Patterson. So recognize what Patterson has given to you." But this election is critically important, ladies and gentlemen, because the city is on a continual down spiral. We need someone to lift it back up. We need someone in that job who actually knows what they're doing. Now, I'm not going to talk about any particular candidates by name. But we have one potential candidate that has run for mayor every time there's been an election for the past few years. He'll show up at every event. He'll go around and shake everybody's hand, whether they're eating or not. He will smile in your face. But if you've been paying attention to this young man's career, he has not made one difficult decision in his entire political career. Every decision he's made has benefited solely him. Then we have another potential candidate that feels it's his birthright to be the mayor simply by his last name. Now, for those of you who don't know what I mean, Patterson has a tendency to vote for folks simply based on their surname. We can no longer do that. If it's the right person for the job, it should not matter what their last name is. But you're going to have a groundswell of support simply because they feel, based on the demographics of the city, they should be mayor. But once again, I ask you to look at their record and see what they have done. Now, they will take credit for doing a lot of things, but if you take a deep dive, you'll find that other people have done those things and they're just taking credit for them. We don't need the pretenders, ladies and gentlemen. There's way too much at stake. Now, you can sit at home, and I don't think anyone in this room is going to sit at home because you folks are informed and you know. But there will be folks who will sit at home and not participate in this election. And they will tell you all kind of things. Now, this isn't the first time that Bill McCoy has considered running for mayor. He's considered it in the past. And I'm almost embarrassed to say it was people who looked like me who said that they would not support him. As a matter of fact, some folks said he wasn't even black. And I said, "I don't know, but I think the cops don't ask him whether he's African American, Jamaican American, West Indian, Trinidad, and when they pull him over, particularly since he drives a BMW." What I'm saying simply, ladies and gentlemen, let's not continue to practice the old norms because they haven't gotten us anywhere. We have to really rethink. If you don't think about your future, think about your children's future. Or think about your parents or your grandparents who are still living in this city in homes that you grew up in that they no longer can afford to stay in. What you need is someone in that office who cares about people, who's a family man, so understands family, family values, and understands what it means to raise children in this city. We need someone who can do the job. We no longer need a figurehead in that office. We need someone who can actually make the hard decisions based on a thorough knowledge of what they need to do. We have a situation in this city that is extremely tenuous. And we have many, many opportunities, but you need the right man in office to enable us to take advantage of those opportunities. It is no coincidence that there's a renewed interest in this city because of the Great Falls. There is no coincidence there is a renewed interest in this city of new development. And if we don't be at the table, then you're part of the menu. Yeah. So we need to bring Bill McCoy to the forefront, and we need to get behind him, and we need to support him, and we need not to be embarrassed about supporting him. Because he's about community, he's about us. That's why I wholeheartedly support him. And those of you who know me, I don't come out publicly and support anybody. I have folks taking pictures with me and they sending out flyers saying that I support him. I had to call one gentleman on that in that last election. I said, you need to stop that because I don't support you. But I am proud and willing to stand next to this man in any venue and say that he's my candidate. Not because of what his name is, not because of what his ethnicity is, it's because he can do the job. So ladies and gentlemen, it gives me pleasure and I am honored to bring to the microphone at this point in time the next mayor of the third largest city of the state of New Jersey, the great city, the Silk City, your next mayor, William the Real.